Born in London, did primary school in Ghana, then I did secondary school up to now in the UK. You know, I came back with an accent, African accent. It automatically put me in a box, you're African, you know, and then there was a certain perception of what Africa, you know, is to these kids. So there wasn't no sense of pride coming back to the UK. I kind of disassociated myself from being African, but I had to just come back to loving myself. And, you know, I guess going back to Ghana to make music really did that. It did a lot for me in terms of me reconnecting with my culture and being proud of, you know, who I am. Any child, you know, who is African, I wanted them to feel proud, and it's happening now. You know, these kids are so proud to be African. They're speaking their own language, they're speaking in Pidgin English, they're playing our music, they're wearing our clothes. You know, it's a beautiful time. I use the success that I have to be able to, you know, help the continent, because it's because of the continent that I'm here that I am the person I am. I made the kind of music that I make. Everything that we're doing now is more than changing mentalities, it's creating a reality. So like from the schools, we're building a school in Ghana, in Akosombo. We've done a primary school, we're now working on the secondary school. It's probably one of the most important projects that I'm working on, because we need to create a syllabus and have a school that teaches the kids that, you know, you're not a slave, you're royalty. You know, and this happened, but you're still royalty. You're strong enough to carry on and think different and become a leader and not feel inferior. I think it's all about embracing our culture and who we truly are. There's nothing better than finding pride in who you are.
So talking about embracing who you are, I know you have some dolls you released,
oh, yes.
And they're called Nana dolls. Yeah?
Nana dolls in the building.
It's got one there, yeah.
I present to you Nana, yeah. She's from Ghana. And these are all based on historical African women. Of course, like, you know, usually historically you don't get black dolls in the toy stores, which is very ridiculous. Outside of Africa and in Africa as well, but they look like them because representation matters. And also they're based on historical African women, so they get to learn. So each doll is from a different country. So one's from, you know, Ghana, Nana, yeah. One's from Zimbabwe, Nehanda. One's from South Africa, Mekeba. And one is from Nigeria, Kuti. So we're working on more.
I was gonna say, none from East Africa.
That's what I was gonna say. We're working on more. We wanna do one for Kenya.
Okay, yeah, and represent.
Also, I think we'll make you look like you as well. I really like your look as well, you know, the natural hair and everything, man. I think we'll do that. But
thank
yeah,
you.
Nana dolls.
So why is it called Nana?
So Nana means king or queen. It's a unisex name from Ghana. It originated from the tree language, and yeah, it's just, it represents, you know, power, a king or a queen. You know, of course, these dolls and these women are queens, and these kids need to understand that they have that power in them to become leaders, you know, and be royalty.
And your name is also Nana.
Yeah, my name is Nana.
So you're a king.
Of course. Your name is Nana too.
Everybody's a Nana.
Yeah, of course.
So I'm Nana Debula Kemoli.
You should already know. Nana Debula.
Yeah.
Welcome to the New African Nation.